We thank beloved Godfrey for initiating this cycle and for being the first in this new nation, the United States of America, to show us the way, to lead us through the Revolutionary War as a general, and then to not accept what some had desired to be the king, to accept the holy office, which we now know is also an office in the universal or great white brotherhood of the president of these United States. So regardless of what we may feel about what some are acclaiming in this time as to their view of history, this is a sacred nation under God, commissioned by the universal and great white brotherhood to fulfill a holy purpose, to be a beacon of freedom, liberty, justice, and divine equality for all peoples of all races, of all cultures. We are more than just a melting pot of peoples from around the world. We are a universal concept of unity. Diversity within unity and unity within diversity. We stand commissioned by God to be that example of the Christ awareness, the Christ principle, the Christ consciousness. George Washington was this, and now as an ascended being, he continues to overshine our United States, to guide it along with the 14 ascended masters who govern the destiny of America, along with beloved Saint Germain, El Morya, and the Chohans of the Rays. And so we celebrate today this sacred institution of God government and how we, the people who co-created this nation, both on the outer and some of us on the inner when it was established, can move it forward into the new era, can deliberate wisely, judiciously, and affectionately toward each other rather than in a divisive way. So we, within our heart center movement and community, see the unity in all life. We feel that unity within all life. We celebrate that unity within all peoples. Even in our differences, differences of opinion, differences of view, differences of how we live. We can live in harmony and in unity if we choose to do so, utilizing the principles, the values of light, of divine justice, of equality of opportunity, and of mercy and kindness, of divine love. So we choose this as a people, a holy people of God. We are the offspring of one of the 12 tribes of Israel and maybe more than one. As we have come here, either been born here or immigrated here, to live within this divine conceptualization of what a nation and a people can be, conceived immaculately by God and the Ascended Masters. And though we understand our history and the injustices that have occurred with the slaughter of some of the native peoples and of slavery, it is behind us. It is not in front of us. It is behind us. We must remember this. We have overcome the injustices of the past, and we have to focus on the new mercies and graces of the future within the eternal now. We can't celebrate a past that was and is no more. We can embrace a future which is happening right before our eyes. And we can choose to love one another, to value each soul, each spirit, each being as God does. And when we do this, we participate in the immaculate image of what America embracing the I am race is. We can do this with divine fanfare as we celebrate our Day of Independence on July 4th, not just as white people or white men. We can do this as one people, as we understand the underlying principles of eternal freedom, of divine justice, and of holy liberty. When we engage in this way, we can be patriotic in the right way, knowing that institutions of government are not perfect and that our leaders are never perfect humanly, yet there is a holy office that we must recognize and observe and honor, especially the presidency, which is, as I said, an office in the universal or great white brotherhood. When we demean an individual holding that office, we demean ourselves because we know the law of the one, that what we do unto another, we do unto the Christ and unto ourselves. Therefore, we must, even if we disagree with some things of what any who hold that office do or how they act, we must recognize the office itself. So, El Morya, Saint Germain, Jesus, and others are calling Americans to be true to the first principles and first cause of how this nation was formed and established under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. An opportunity, an equal opportunity to rise from any level into where any man, woman, and child desires to go through this freedom of opportunity.